It's been around a decade since the last Harry Potter movie was released. Harry Potter movies did not only include mind-baffling magical things, but also some sci-fi stuffs mixed with magic. Harry Potter's invisibility cloak was one of them. It had established a worldwide wonder among the teenagers and gave birth to several ideas and theories of achieving invisibility. How to become invisible? It's a question most of us has asked or been asked at some point. There are millions of searches all over the internet on how to achieve invisibility. Before discussing that, let's understand why we are visible. We are made up of matter. In fact, everything we see around us is made up of matter. Matters are subdivided into smaller constituents like molecules, which are big enough to reflect the light coming from a particular source. The light that makes things visible falls under electromagnetic spectrum and is known as visible spectrum. The light that is outside the visible spectrum does not interact with physical objects the same way as the visible spectrum. Gamma rays, for example, are too small and fast to interact with physical objects. Radio waves are too large and slow, which is why radio waves pass straight through the walls of your house. From the perspective of these forms of light, the walls of your house are invisible. But the visible light gets reflected from the walls and enters our eyes, making things visible. Now, let's get back to our previous discussion. How to become invisible? The general answer will be to cut off the reflection of light or to cut off the supply of light. Cutting off the total supply of light or staying in a dark room will make you invisible. That means you'll not be visible, but still you'll be slimmable, fleeable, touchable, hearable, and tasteable. The word invisible is kinda misleading. Invisible means you are not visible to eyes, but you can still be traced out by other senses. And Harry Potter's invisibility cloak comes under partial invisibility because it can make you invisible from naked eyes, but your presence can be felt and your body can be touched. So, how to achieve true invisibility? If we want to achieve true invisibility, we will have to turn every single atom and molecules of our body into non-rigid stuffs. If we can do so, we will gain actual invisibility and no other human senses will be able to trace our presence. But for now, it is just a theoretical idea. As mentioned before, Harry Potter's invisibility cloak comes under partial invisibility and it is relatively easier to achieve. Visual cloaking allows us to render objects or simply to redirect the light around the shape from all the directions in order to make that object disappear to the naked eye. The earliest cloaking devices used back in 2006 were composed of metamaterials. Physicists rendered a cylinder invisible by coating it with metamaterial, but unlike Potter's robes, people could guess that something fishy was going on. In 2012, scientists at MIT moved to playing with electrons instead of light to develop an electron cloaking material. Then in 2014, a research group at University of Rochester came up with a breakthrough implementation of visual cloaking. The device was first to perform three-dimensional multi-directional cloaking, which works for transmitting rays in the visible spectrum. The cloaking devices developed earlier worked fine when you look at this object straight on, but as soon as the viewpoint is changed, it is possible to perceive this cloaking device and the object becomes visible. This new system won't conceal you entirely, but it has its advantages. It can allow surgeons to see through their hands what they're operating on their patients, or eliminate blind spots for truck drivers in vehicles. Making fully functional invisibility cloak is still a part of science fiction, but soon we may achieve some scientific advancement. But until then, we'll just have to leave invisibility to Hollywood.